Get out. Welcome back, Orlando. Boy, I'm making a power fail this time. I love it. Hey, did everyone have a good lunch? Yes, wonderful. So what do we do now? We need dancers. Who's willing to be my dancers out here? Help me out on stage. Let's rock it.
Everybody get ready. Walk it up. One, two, three. Hey, girl!
Well, first of all, I want to thank you all for giving me a chance to share a little bit of what I'm developing. Again, this is all part of the Global Mastermind program. I'm in my second year. And some of us are able to opt to train to become trainers. So thank you so much for letting me do this. And are you ready to have a little bit of fun?
Yeah!
I said, are you ready to have a little bit of
fun?
Fabulous. So, if you recall, virtually every single presenter that we saw this week talked to us about mindset, didn't they? Yeah. They said, it's critical, this will not work if you don't have the perfect mindset. Yes or yes?
Yes.
Right. And they said that in order to make this work, you have to do whatever it takes. Yes?
Yes.
So what exactly, though, does that mean? It's a little bit, I don't know, to me it's a little bit ambivalent. Someone says, just do whatever it takes. Like, I don't know what that means. Give it everything that I have. So what is the it? So here's a question. I want everyone, just don't say it out loud, but think of one reason that you might not succeed. Don't say it out loud, I'll give you one or two reasons. Does everyone have them? Okay, I want you to think. Now, those reasons that you just came up with, who gave them to you? Was it your neighbor? Was it someone back in the 14? No, right, it was, guess what? It's the same mind that you're gonna take home and say, hey, mind, we have a week's worth of information, let's go become a millionaire. Right?
Right.
Slight, slight problem with that. Yes or yes?
Yes.
Who also has heard the saying that we are our own worst enemy?
Yes.
Right? Who finds that sometimes they are their own worst enemy? Anyone?
Yeah.
So let's be logical here. Would you leave this room and go out and search out your own worst enemy and make them chief financial officer and CEO of your company and say, here, make millions for me. Is that like a good idea?
I don't think so.
Right, okay, so you can see there that there's a slight issue there. So would it be okay if I tell you a little bit about my story?
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Yes. So who of you has had a dream when you were little, just a dream, and you were told that you could do anything because if you put your mind to it, it's possible? Who's had their dream just shattered and pulled out from them at some point, who to this day just hasn't quite gotten where they thought they would? I know you're heading to go up to outer space. Dave, you said we're going to outer space, literally.
Did you sign up?
Yes.
Really?
So I started out, I was probably the most optimistic person you'd ever seen. I went to the best schools. I went to a wonderful prep school. I went to Georgetown University. I was set, and I did not care that Socrates and Plato had tried to conquer this issue. I was going to do it. I was single-handedly going to find the solution to happiness, and I was going to share it with everybody. Yeah. Didn't quite work. Life had a few other plans for me. Even though my classmates said that the movie Legally Blonde, has anyone seen the movie Legally Blonde?
Yeah.
Was modeled after me. Thank you. Although I did not have a dog in school, I promise. I went out and I struggled. I had financial devastation, and I'm smart. And I had all the tools in the world. And nothing was working. Even my relationships were falling apart. So at one point, I realized that I had to ask better questions. I had to look in a different direction. Maybe it wasn't out there. Maybe the answer was in here, in my inner game. Has anyone ever thought that before?
Yeah.
Right, so I began working and working. And then almost like magically and mysteriously, things started getting better. I started working on pivoting. I started working on retelling a more empowering story. I started working on the law of energy, or the law of attraction. And all of a sudden, well, little did I know that the biggest and most important degree that I would ever get in my life would not be from one of those amazing institutions, but it would be from the school of what some people call
hard knocks.
Hard knocks.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. And the most important degree that I would get would be in this what I call inner technology. I had the ultimate test of this, ironically enough, not even in my business. On February 19th, my youngest child graduated from Yale and went down to South America. She was the biggest and the brightest. I get a call on February 19, 2016. You need to come to Colombia. I'm dreadfully sorry. This is Dana, Skylar's friend. Skylar has been crushed by a boulder, and her head has been split open. And we don't, the doctors don't know if they can keep her alive long enough for you to come and get the body. Has anyone had a situation where you almost lost yourself or lost someone that you love? It's devastating, isn't it? It's a very disempowering feeling. So I won't kid you, I probably cried more tears than any human being should cry in one lifetime. But here's the difference. Because I had started this training and I'd started other training about the inner game, I said, wait a minute, it can't work in my business and not work every other place in my life. So I started playing the inner game, and I found the place of such knowing in the form of expectation that life had to conform to my vision, regardless of the textbook, okay? Skylar survived. Things that were impossible became our reality. We became the miracle family. So let me assure you, when you walk out of this room, there will be obstacles. You might even encounter monsters, or even literally a boulder. But nowhere is it written that we are defined by the terrible, damaging things that happen to us. We are mightier and we are bolder than those things that would try to leave us permanently scarred. I wear my scars like a crown of gems. My scars cry out that I was bigger and tougher than the frickin' boulders that would try to take me down. Can anyone else relate? Yes or yes? So I'm telling you, if you want to be a millionaire, if you really want it, you have got to oust that frickin' enemy voice in your head. You've got to get it out. And it's not just a matter of being positive and looking on the bright side. I promise you I tried, okay? So, what I have dedicated myself to in my training is to what I call the it factor. I train people to take their impossibles and make it impossible using inner technology. Even Harv himself said that you can give people the best tools in the world, but if there is a hole in the toolbox, you've got a tremendous issue. So turn to your neighbor and say, welcome to the it factor. Yes? So who has a phone out there? Anyone using a phone that is 10 years old or older? No? Computer then, that's 10 years or older. Okay, very few. So we all agree that it's really important to update your technology. But what technology do we forget to even recognize, much less update our inner technology, yes? So I don't have time to teach you all of the different components, but let me just quickly show you. These are some of the components that I broke down, and that for me, in my experience, that when I address those, when I can start to master those, then I was able to be in a position where I could achieve miracles in my own life, whether it was my business or even with literally life and death with my daughter. So these are some of the aspects. Like I said, I don't have time to train you on all of them, but who likes football out there? Just for now, even if you don't. So I'm gonna play a little game that has to do with anchoring. Who's heard of anchoring? Anchoring is when you take an association that you have in your life that may not serve you, and you replace it with something positive. So who would agree that we need to leave here with positive anchoring if we're gonna possibly confront that enemy within? Yes? Great. Okay, so here's the scoop.
Wait.
Oh, go ahead. So when I tell you, when I tell you, right, woohoo, you got it, girl. You are going to get with a partner. Choose someone close to you, but there's going to be a partner A and a partner B, and the one who has like the coolest shirt is partner A and gets to go first. okay? Remember, that whole Legally Blonde thing, right? Okay? So, what you're going to do, may I change this?
Yep.
Okay. So what you're going to do, there's just some simple rules. It'll take approximately 3 minutes.
Yeah.
So with your partner, in the silence of your mind, you're going to pick out your song. Because who's seen the guys really celebrate in the end zone?
Yeah.
Yes? Okay. This is you. You are living your Super Bowl, everybody. Your entire life is your Super Bowl. So you darn well better learn how to celebrate in the end zone. Okay? So, you're going to pick out your song, what your song would be. You're going to pick out a victory pose or a victory dance, something that tells your mind, I am a champion, I rock, okay? So then, what I want each of you to do is imagine yourself, visualize you have made it. You're up in outer space. What are you going to smell? What are you going to be thinking? What are you going to be cheering out? What is this moment like for you? Then we're gonna go, A is gonna go first, and at the top of your lungs, like you're out in a freaking arena, the crowd is cheering and roaring, and you are yelling, I am Meredith Higginson! I just got my $25,000 retreat, etc., etc., etc. You're gonna have about a minute to do that, but you're gonna finish by telling them what their victory song is, and you're gonna say, I, Meredith Higginson, I am unstoppable! I play this game to win. And then B partner, you're gonna say, I see it. That is who you are. And then when we leave this room, if you're on your way to your $1 million deal, you play that song in your car. You play that song. Before you go out of the house, you strike your pose and you say, we are unstoppable. And we play this game to win. And start watching the difference. So everybody ready to get a partner?
Yeah.
Partner up, and if you end up without a partner, please put your hand up in the air. So you have about 30 seconds to figure out what would be your victory song.
Yeah, you're right.
And what it's going to taste like, smell like, feel like when you are in your own personal end zone. I'll give you about 30 seconds to start visualizing that.
Okay, so.
And it can even be what are you saying to people in your life?
So you want to be A?
Yeah.
Sydney. Okay. Nice to see you. Meet you. I'm Elizabeth. I'm Sydney.
Okay. Are you ready? When I say three, who are my partner? Who are my A partners here? Who are my A partners? Hey, this is the Super Bowl, guys. We are in the locker room. Show me my A partners.
Yay!
My A partners. You just got your own personal touchdown in the most important Super Bowl game of your life. Shout it out to your B partner. How do you feel? What is your song? What are you gonna do in this moment? Go!
Okay.
whatever highway you are on, that the people next to you are going to be looking at you like, what the heck is going on with this person? As you play your song so loud that your freaking eardrums are blasting and exploding away, you are going to learn to celebrate, because that's the way you get rid of that enemy in between those ears. You do not want that enemy to be the CFO of your company as you go out to make your millions. So can I give you one more little trick that has worked? And this goes back into banishing that enemy, because it can be done. Believe it or not, this is not a given. You were not born in the crib with that voice saying that you can't. If you look back to when you were a child, you could do anything. You could eat grass, you could jump out a window, you could do anything. There was nothing. You could go to the moon. There is still time to be that anything in your life. So who's had the experience when they're listening to like their best friend? You can kind of call them out pretty easily when something isn't supporting them, when their logic is flawed and tainted by a story, right? What if you could take that little enemy and you could get across to your subconscious mind, guess what? You've been just living in me. You're not me. So here's a little trick that works with a lot of people that I work with. Very simple. If you're a guy, pick a very disrespectful name. Like, I love Poindexter personally. Poindexter. If you're a woman, same thing. Well, it can be Myrtle, it can be whatever, and I hope they're no more Myrtles. But, so here's what I do, right? When that little nasty enemy voice starts talking to me, I'll say Myrtle. What were Dennis's favorite words?
Thanks for sharing.
Thanks for sharing, Myrtle. But Meredith and I don't think that way. Now, you're welcome to join us anytime you want to, but for now, you just go over there with that. Meredith is very positive. Positive. There's nothing that she can't do. Meredith and I are going to examine this situation, and we'll make the decision from here. Yes?
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Try that for 30 days and see if that enemy voice doesn't start disappearing. Fire that frickin' CFO, okay?
Yeah.
All right. So, we're kind of coming to the end, so I want to leave you with one last little message. You ready? Unveiling. If you take nothing else from what I have said, please remember, it is your mind's world. You just live in it. So that boulder for me, that wasn't a lesson in how to face death. That boulder became a message in how to choose to live. I'm urging you, if you take nothing else from GBS, take that decision that you, not that enemy, will choose how to live and how to make your millions. And go make your millions and get your it together. Yes or yes?
Yes!
I'm Meredith Hankinson, Alexander, and thank you!
You're amazing. You're amazing. You're giving them a big round of applause. Thank you. You're very welcome. That was awesome.
Thank you.
So don't forget to give her feedback later, okay? What worked, what didn't work, what she could do better next time. Got that? That will help her again. And so you can slip it to just a piece of paper, because everybody telling her that would take a long time. All right, have a seat. She'll just clear her stuff and life is good. Thank you again. That was awesome. You know, the one thing about Meredith, and especially people who are on this road with us, is they just show up to a lot of events, too. Does that make sense? I mean, they've already bought everything anyway, but Meredith is always asking me, where are you doing a celebration day? Where are you doing a piece where I can do a small piece? And they just fly and they show up. So for her, it doesn't matter in the country where it is. Everybody got that? We've had people come with us and say, you're going to be in Sydney? Do you need some help? I'll fly down. And it's not like it's about the money or not the money. One of the students who did that for us, Lee in Atlanta,